We can start our other presentation. Professor Hümeyra Orucu from Ege Üniversitesi, Turkey. Her presentation is going to be as a pre-recording. She is joining us from the APMAS conference. Her presentation is phosphor-based white light generation. Professor, thank you. Welcome again.
Thank you so much.
If you are ready, I am going to start your presentation.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for your kind invitation. It's my pleasure to have opportunity to give a talk here. The topic of my talk is nanophosphors for phosphor-based white light generation. The talk is organized as follows. After a general introduction about the phosphors and applications, a section about the experimental findings related to the lanthanide-3-dot garnet structure will be presented. In this respect, I will give main points of material and method, XRD result, scanning electron microscopy photos, luminescence spectroscopy results, and conclusions. The luminescence materials are generally known as phosphors. Phosphors can be composed of activator and the host lattice. The activator cations can consist of various transition metal and rare earth ions. Phosphor materials find technological and industrial applications such as white light emitting diodes, lasers, biological label, temperature sensors, solar cells, and display devices with better energy saving, color rendering, high efficiency capacity. The upconversion or downconversion phosphors exhibit many prominent optical features. Upconversion phosphors can be used effectively to convert the ultraviolet and near-infrared part of the solar spectrum into electricity as a spectral converter for solar cells. With high-power infrared LED diodes, upconversion phosphors may find many uses in sensing, solid-state full-color displays, lasers, and biological fluorescent labels. Down-conversion phosphors also find applications in white light-emitting diodes. Nanocrystalline materials are usually defined as solids with particle diameter ranging from few nanometers up to 100 nanometer. Significant changes in the optical properties have been observed with decreasing particle size. For example, nanophosphors have gained interest as luminescence markers for medical diagnosis as well as biological labels. We can summarize main benefits as compared with conventional luminescence materials, upconversion nanophosphors have relatively longer lifetime. Secondly, lanthanide dope upconversion nanophosphors show sharp emission bands with 10-20 nanometer full width with half maximum value under a certain wavelength of 980 nanometer light excitation. The near-infrared light excitation provides deep penetration and low tissue damage for in vivo imaging. White light-emitting diodes are lightning sources with mercury-free and better power output. White light-emitting diodes lamps require 10 times less energy than ordinary light bulbs. And in light-emitting diodes, electricity is directly converted into light. The problem with traditional incandescent bulbs is that only 10% of their energy goes toward the production of light. And LEDs are also more long-lasting than other lamps. For example, while fluorescent lamps usually last around 10,000 hours, LEDs can last for 100,000 hours. Light-emitting diodes lamps are flexible light sources that millions of different colors can be produced. The colors and intensity can be varied as needed. They can reproduce the alternation of natural lights and follow our biological clock. Greenhouse cultivation is also using artificial LED lightning. Here. White light via LEDs can be performed in two ways. Multi-chip LEDs which contain three individual monochromatic red, green, and blue emitting LEDs can be used together, and I do the work combining the three colors into white. Secondly, phosphor converted light emitting diodes, which include the coating of red and green phosphors on blue LED chips, as shown in figure. When exciting a phosphor material with blue LED, light is emitting in the green and red spectral ranges, which combined with blue light appears as white, or combination of red, green, and blue phosphors with ultraviolet LED chips here. The other effective ways of generating white light is the upconversion, in which low energy near infrared excitation is converted into higher energy such as ultraviolet or visible via multiple absorption and energy transfer processes through lanthanide doping. The intensity of the blue, green, and red upconversion emissions can be changed properly, adjusting the concentrations of lanthanide ions. Researchers studied color control and white light generation of upconversion luminescence by operating lanthanide dope amounts on mono, co-doped, or tri-doped nanopowders. Nanopowders synthesis methods are also known to affect the control of energy transfer in nanophosphors and tune multicolor emission. Inorganic materials activated by rare earth ions are promising hosts for white light generation studies. Related lanthanide doped nanophosphors as host materials can be garnets, alumina silicates, orthometallates, nitrites and oxynitrites, sulfates, and oxide materials. We will present our latest research on the luminescence properties of rare earth triple dot oxide monocrystalline phosphors with upconversion mechanism. The optical and magnetic characteristics of material depend critically on the method of preparation. So we have chosen gadolinium gallium garnet structure. It is an important host material for optical laser and magnetic applications and belongs to cubic system with a garnet structure. It has high thermal conductivity, good chemical stability, and interesting optical properties. So this is the figure for unit cell of gadolinium gallium garnet. We can see that gadolinium occupy dodecahedral sides here, and gallium occupies octahedral and tetrahedral framework. In this study, the ytterbium, erbium, tullium, tri-doped gadolinium gallium garnet nanophosphor powders were synthesized by Sol-gel Pacini method at the calcinic temperature of 800 to 1200 Celsius degree by using citric and nitric acid as chelating agent and polyethylene glycol as cross-digging agent. And their optical behaviors are studied by controlling the excitation power of 975 nanometer laser as the excitation source. The Sol-gel Pacini method chosen because it offers the advantage of high purity, uniformity, and low temperature processing. We can see gadolinium gallium garnet fast diagram here. Molar ratio of gadolinium gallium is determined 0.56 and the material is labeled as gadolinium gallium garnet GGG. In this figure, we can see the preparation process for garnet structures. High purity gallium, gadolinium, and rare earth nitrate regions were dissolved nitric acid under stirring. The solution was heated to 65 under continuous stirring using a magnetic agitator. The suitable amount of citric acid was mixed as chelating agent to the solution. Then a quantity of polyethylene glycol was used as cross-link agent. The obtained solution was continuously stirred at 65 Celsius degree for 2 hours until the highly transparent sol became gel by slow evaporation. After aging, the gel sintered in a muffled furnace, alternating temperatures from 800 to 1200 Celsius degree for 2 hours. The resulting powders lightly crushed in an agate mortar to fine powders. Ytterbium-erbium concentrations peaked 2 and 1% mole, respectively, and tolium concentration changes as 0.5, 1 and 1.5% mole. And we can see the soil and nanopowder figures here. The crystalline fast structure was determined by X-ray diffractometer. Scanning electron microscopy images were used to characterize the structural and morphological properties of powders. XRD results of the obtained powders confirmed the formation of well-crystallized gadolinium gallium garnet at relatively low temperature, 800 Celsius degree for 2 hours here. As the sintering temperature increased, the intensity of the peaks becomes strength and the shape of the peaks becomes narrow. The diffraction peak at 30 degree here indicates that another intermediate phase, trigadolinium gallate, was also formed after 1000 Celsius degree. The grain size distribution was analyzed by Plazek full width 1/5, 4/5 maxima method, which can be applied to the crystalline powders. The average grain size distribution nanopowders annealed at 800 and 1000 Celsius degree were calculated from the grain size distribution curves as 14 here and 21 nanometer respectively. The sample exhibits a slight broader size distribution after heat treatment. From the sample results, it can be observed that nanopowders are agglomerated and there are spherical nanoparticles in the structure. Sintered at 800 Celsius degree for 2 hours with the particle diameter ranging around 500 nanometer. Here, 100,000 Celsius degree for 2 hours samples shown. At high temperatures, nanoparticles split into smaller particles and then they start to agglomerate into a network. Again, this is the third picture, sample photos for 1,200 Celsius degree nanophosphors. The upconversion emission spectra of YET1 nanophosphor were measured between 400 and 850 nanometer wavelength region using 975 nanometer laser diode as a function of the laser excitation power up to 4 watts. The upconversion emission intensities of nanopowders show a continuous increase as the power increases. We have got blue, green, red, and violet regions. Blue region, blue emission maximum at 475 nanometer, green 525 and 555 nanometer, red 654 and 670 nanometer regions. The blue emission is attributed to the transition of thulium ions here, and the green emission corresponding to transitions of erbium and erbium ions, and the red region, red emission region, is ascribed to transitions of erbium and thulium ions respectively. As the temperature increases, the intensity of upconversion emission of nanopowders increases here, we can see. And this is for YET sample. If we change the sample YET2, again, the intensity of emission increase with the annealing temperature here. And this is the third sample here. Again, the intensity of the emission increases with the annealing temperature. As the thulium ion concentration increases, the intensity of conversion emission decreases, as we can see here, and spectral profiles of blue, green, red regions changes. Now we will define two color quality parameters. One of them is color temperature, and the other is color rendering index. Low color temperature implies warmer light, while high color temperature appears to be colder, more blue light here. Color rendering index is a unitless index, abbreviated variously as CRI. Discharge measures a scale from 0 to 100, depending on how accurately it can produce light that matches a naturally referenced light sources such as sun. In general, bulbs at the higher end of the scale here will produce more accurate color rendering of the objects around it. The International Commission of Illumination Coordinates and correlated color temperatures, color rendering indexes under 0.5 watt excitation laser power are listed in this table 2. As annealing temperature increases, correlated color temperature of the nanopowers decrease. So we can see the nanoscale single phase effect here. And as the dopant concentration increases, the color coordinates of the nanopowders shifts to the higher region. So we can see positive effect of high thulium ions, additions of high thulium ions. We can summarize that Bright white up conversion emission has been observed for GGG YET3 sample at 800 Celsius degree here. So we have got 2% ytterbium, 1% erbium, and maximum concentration of thulium, 1.5% thulium in this sample. Here we can see spectral emissions and CIE diagram of this sample nanophosphors in this region with the coordinates and camera image shown in this figure. And the other sample, again, doped with the same concentrations, but annealed at 1000 Celsius degree here, the coordinates, CIE coordinates changes and see color rendering index decreasing. Before it was 89, now after annealed at 1000 Celsius degree, it decreases to 70. And the last one, if the sample annealed at 1200 Celsius degree, again, color rendering index decreases and the coordinates of the CIE is changing. As a conclusion, we can summarize ytterbium, erbium, thulium, tridoped, gadolinium, gallium, garnet, nanophosphors were successfully obtained at 800 Celsius degree annealing temperature for 2 hours without second phase by sol-gel Pacini method. The average crystal size is calculated as in the range 20-30 nanometer at 800 Celsius degree annealing temperature. The intensity of the blue, green, and red upconversion emissions can be changed by properly adjusting the concentration of the ytterbium, erbium, thulium ions, and annealing temperatures. Nanopowders show spherical bubble forms made of thin spherical shells with the particle diameter ranging around 500 nanometer at 800 and 1000 Celsius degree. Scanning electron microscopy and XRD line broadening show that the crystal size grows and the diameter and the number of nanobubbles decrease with increasing annealing temperature. The chromaticity coordinates of 1.5 mol% ratios of ytterbium, erbium, tellurium, gadolinium, gallium, garnet, nanocrystalline phosphor annealed at 800 Celsius degree fell in the white region of CIE diagram with high color rendering index value. It's about 89. Bright white upconversion emission has been observed from the samples for when excited with 975 nanometer emission of laser diode. And CIE chromaticity coordinates for white emission in this phosphor were found to be 0.3060 and 0.3661 under 975 nanometer laser diode excitation. The experimental results show that this phosphor should be a potential material for white light sources, solar cells, displays, and LEDs. I want to acknowledge my collaborators, Professor Gönül Erirek, Associated Professor Murat Erdem, Sevcan Tabanlı, Selim Burak, Can Türk, and these are the references for this talk. Thank you for everything.
Yes, Professor Hümeyra Örücü, thank you, yeah, participant of this conference and also this interesting presentation. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Just now, we can take questions. Yes, I want to say to all participants, is there any participant have any questions to Professor Hümeyra Örücü? You can write the chat section, or if you want to ask by yourself, please write the chat part. We can open your voice from the host section. I think there is no question for now. If anyone wants to ask anything about this presentation, you can send email Professor Örücü.
Of course.
I think she's going to help you about your questions. Professor, thank you again.
Thank you so much.
You are welcome. Yes. And also just now we are going to be in coffee break about 80 minutes. After the coffee break, we are going to our conference section with one of the another pre-recording presentation from Biomedsen invited speaker, Professor Snezana Ilic Stojanovic. Yes. Okay.